Are you looking to acquire the increased gift card sales this holiday season? Do you want a good customer engagement in your online store? Are you searching for a safe and secured gift card system for your online business? So turn to Ultimate WooCommerce Gift Cards and earn a huge profits with an all-in-one digital gifting system. Hello everyone, this is Drishti with Make Web Better, and guys, I welcome all of you to the Make Web Better sessions of demo videos and tutorials. So in today's video, we are going to have a demonstration on the updated features and functionalities of the premium version of our gift cards plugin, which is Ultimate WooCommerce Gift Cards. But before that, let us first understand the basic definition. So guys, Ultimate WooCommerce Gift Cards is a gift card plugin that will help you create and sell the customizable gift cards to your customers with the added benefits including custom coupon codes feature, QR and barcode, gift cards redemption and much more. So this in turn is going to help you strengthen your cash flow, increase the rate of customer engagement and improve your brand awareness. So guys, let's first of all watch the video and understand that how this plugin works on your WordPress website and give sales driven outcomes. So first of all, let us first understand that how to set up Ultimate Gift Cards for WooCommerce. So guys, the very first thing that you have to do is move to your WordPress dashboard and then click on plugins and then click on add new. And over here you have to search for gift cards. So guys, as soon as you search for gift cards, you will get the different list of the gift card plugins. So let's search it, and here is the plugin which is the free version, and you can also get it on wordpress.org. So simply guys, what you have to do is you have to click on install now, and just after this you have to click on the activate option that you'll be getting. So simply click on activate, and as soon as you are going to click on activate, this plugin will get activated, and as you can see the status right over here. So guys, this is the free version of gift cards, which is Ultimate Gift Cards for WooCommerce. So that has been activated, and right after this what you have to do is upload the premium version file. Simply you have to click on add new and click on upload plugin right from here, and from here you have to upload the zip format of your plugin. So I'm going to do this process, and let me show you that how can you do it. Simply you have to select the folder from your system and then click on install now. So just after clicking on install now, you will get the status of the plugin installation. As you can see, all the files are getting uploaded, and then after you have to click on activate plugin. So just after going to click on this option, this plugin, which is the premium version, will get activated. So guys, this is how in quick steps you can get both the versions of gift cards on your WordPress website. And now just click on settings, and I'm going to show you all the general settings that are involved in this process. So guys, this is the overview section that you'll be getting as soon as you have installed the plugin on your system, on your WordPress website. And over here you can see the basic definition of the plugin. You can understand the different benefits and the advantages that you'll be getting for your gift cards business. And just after this, I'm going to show you that what are the different general settings that are involved in setting up the gift cards plugin on your system. So guys, first of all, to enable the plugin, you have to enable this functionality to enable the plugin on your and then if you want to enable the tax calculation on the gift card, so simply you have to enable this functionality. So let's enable this. And guys, just after this, the next feature that comes up is enable listing shop page. So if you want to enable gift card product listings right on the shop page, you have to enable this option. And after this comes, if you want to enable the individual usage of the gift cards by your customers, you have to enable this functionality right over here. And so let's enable this option. And if you don't want to provide this facility, you have to disable this. Next is to provide the free shipping facility on the gift cards to your customers, you have to enable this functionality. Next comes gift card coupon link. So guys, right now we have selected this value as 5. You can set the values as per your needs and the requirements that you have. Next is to set the prefix for your gift card coupon. You can make the changes right over here. Right now we have set it as MWB. Now depending upon what you want to place it, you can set the prefix. Next is gift card expiry after days. So over here you have to set the number of days after which the gift card coupons will get expired. Now for example, if you are setting the value 0 over here, that means you are providing the facility to your customers that they can use the gift cards for unlimited purpose. So right now we have set the value as 365, and you can set the days as per your needs and the requirements. After this comes this minimum spend and the maximum spend. So guys, basically you have to set the amount over here at which your customers can avail the gift cards and enjoy the gift card coupons during their online shopping. Next is gift card number of times users. So using this feature and functionality, you can set the number of times your customers can use the gift cards. So for example, if you set this value 0 over here, that means they can use it on the unlimited purpose. Next is enable date feature. So guys, if you want to enable the date feature, that is you can set the date on which the gift cards will be sent to your customers, you have to enable this functionality right over here. And if you have enabled this functionality, so definitely you will have to select the date format. So these are the different options that you can see in the drop down. You can set it as per your needs and the requirements. So let me select this option. After this comes the payment gateway. So guys, basically for the testing purpose, we have selected the cash on delivery for the shopping functionality, but still there are so many gateway options that you want to provide to your customers. You can set it. For example, there is direct bank transfer, so you can add these options also. Next feature comes is disable category. So guys, if you want to change the category for the gift card products, you have to enable this functionality. And if you don't want to enable this functionality, simply you have to disable it, because every time you're going to create the gift card product, we will have to select the gift card category. And after this, after making all the settings, you have to click on save changes. So guys, since we have done all the settings, what I will do is I will click on save changes. And this is how quickly you can make all the general settings for your gift cards product. Now guys, we are going to discuss that how can you select the products and the product categories for giving the gift card coupons to your customers. So till now we have discussed about the general settings. Now we are going to configure the product settings. So simply click on this tab, which is product, and here comes the product settings. So guys, as you can see over here, the very first functionality is exclude sale items. So guys, if you do not want to provide the gift card coupons to your customers on the products that are on sale, so you have to enable this functionality from here. The next feature that comes up is exclude products. So over here, you have to select all those products on which the gift card coupons will not be applicable, and your customers will not be able to get coupons if they are going to add these selected products into their cards. Next is exclude product category. So you have to select the product category over here on which the gift card coupons will not be applicable. The next feature that comes up is include products. So guys, over here you have to select all those products on which the gift card coupons will be applicable as soon as your customer is going to add these selected products into their shopping carts. So you can select the products according to your needs and the requirements from the options. Next comes include product category. So over here you have to select all those categories on which gift card coupons will be applicable, and your customers will be able to get them as soon as they are going to add all the products coming into the selected product categories. And then you have to click on save changes. So guys, this is how quickly and easily you can configure the product settings, and you can select those products and categories on which you have to give gift card coupons to your customers. Now guys, we are going to discuss that how to configure email settings for the gift card products. So first of all, you have to upload the default logo image from here. So first of all, let's remove this image from here, and let me show you that how can you upload the image. So either you can go with the URL, or you can upload the file from your system. So let's mention the image URL over here, and you can also mention the title if you want, and then you have to click on insert into post. So yes, we have clicked on this, and you can see that the image has been uploaded. Next comes logo height and logo width. So from here you have to set the height and the width, and those settings are in pixels, so you can also change the values. Next is email default event image. You have to upload the image over here that would appear by default in the email template that you are going to send to your customers. Next is gift card message link. So over here you have to mention the length of the gift card message. Now it depends upon the content that you're going to have in your gift card email. Next is disclaimer text. So guys, if you want to mention the disclaimer text over here that would describe about the gift card to your customer, so you can have it over here. And after this, what comes is email settings. So first is gift card email subject. So guys, over here you have to mention the email subject that would notify the receivers about their gift cards. Next is email subject to the sender. So over here you have to mention this email subject that would be sent to the receiver of the gift card, and you can also use the short code that would get replaced with the recipient email address. And over here you have to mention the email content. Next is downloadable gift card email subject for buyer. So guys, over here you have to mention the subject, if the subject that would be sent to the receiver if they are purchasing the gift cards using downloadable delivery option. Next comes gift card email subject for admin. So here you have to mention the email subject that would notify the admin that the gift card has been purchased and now it is ready to be shipped. Next settings that comes up is coupon mail settings. So guys, first of all comes is coupon mail subject. So here you have to mention the subject that would be sent to the receiver of the gift cards when they have used the coupon amounts. And here you have to mention the content, email content that would notify the user that how much amount they have used, how much gift card amount they have used, and how much gift card amount is left to be used. And then you have to click on save changes. So guys, this is how easily you can configure the email settings, and you must have observed how easy these settings are to create the email notifications for your buyers after they have purchased the gift cards from you. Now guys, we are going to discuss that how can you provide the different gift card delivery options to your customers. So for that, first of all, you have to move to the tab which is delivery method, as you can see over here. And the very first option that you can see is enable email to recipient. So guys, if you want to provide gift cards to your customers via email, you have to enable this functionality. So simply we have enabled this option. And next comes is enable downloadable. So if you want to provide the facility to your customers with which they can download the gift cards, you have to enable this functionality. And the third delivery option is shipping. So if you enable this functionality, your customers can get the gift cards with the shipping. Moreover, your customers can also choose out of the three delivery options: email, downloadable, or shipping. So guys, for example, if your customers have selected for the shipping delivery option, so they'll be soon getting the email on the shipping. So for that, using this functionality, which is email for ship your card delivery method, you have to set the email content over here, which will be sent to the gift card recipient if they are selected for shipping or delivery option. Then after this, the next feature that comes is apply coupon on shipping. So guys, if you want to provide coupons on the shipping price of the product, so you have to enable this feature. And moreover, this coupon amount will be applicable to the entire card subtotal. So this is how you have to enable all these settings, and this is how easily you can provide the different delivery options to your customers, and this is how this setting of delivery works. Now guys, we are going to discuss that what are the different other settings that is involved in Ultimate WooCommerce gift cards plugin. So basically in this section we'll understand how to disable and enable the front end elements. So for that, first of all you have to click on other settings tab, and here comes the different options in other settings, and the very first one that you can see is disable apply coupon fields. So guys, if you are going to enable this functionality, then your customers won't be able to apply discount coupon codes on the cart and the checkout page. So depending upon your needs, you have to enable this feature. The next feature that comes up is disable preview button. So guys, if you do not want your customers to see the preview of the gift card product on the front end, then you have to enable this functionality. So accordingly, we have enabled this. Now depending upon your business requirements, you have to set this option. Next is enable VCC option for gift card email. So if you are going to enable this functionality, then the buyer of your gift card product and the recipient of the gift card product would be getting the same emails. Now if you want to disable the resend button on the front end, you have to enable this feature right from here. And next, if you want to disable the quantity option that your customers would be able to upgrade or decrease, so you have to enable this functionality. Now next is disable send today button. Now if you enable this functionality, then your customers won't be able to get the send today button on the front end with which they can send the gift card to their loved ones on that particular day only. And if you want to keep this option enabled, so simply you have to disable this feature. Next is enable PDF feature. So guys, if you are going to enable this functionality, then your customers would also be getting the PDF format of the gift card in the email, and that PDF format would be attached in that. And if you're going to enable this feature, so definitely you will have to select the PDF format. There are two formats, you can set it as per your needs and the requirements. Next functionality that comes up is enable browse image for gift card. So if you enable this functionality, then your customers would be able to browse the image for their gift card products that they are going to buy. The next, next guys, you can see that these are the different fields, like to field, to name, from field, and gift card message. Now, it entirely will depend upon your needs and the requirements that what fields you want to show on the front end to your customers. Now, for example, if I enable the first two options, then your customers won't be able to see these two fields on the front end, which is to and to name. Okay. Now, for example, if I keep the next two options as disabled, this means that your customers would be able to see these two fields on the front end, which is from field and gift card message field. Now, for example, if I enable this functionality, which means that now your customers won't be able to see the gift card message field on the front end. So this is how this feature works. The next setting that comes up is manual increment usage count for gift card coupon. So guys, if you enable this functionality, that means you can increase the number of times your customers can use the gift card coupons. Next is, if you want to hide the gift card notice on the front end, you have to enable this functionality right from here. And next is, most of the times it happens that you don't want to show the terms and conditions on the front end, so you can enable this feature. And similarly, you have to mention the content respectively for that terms and conditions section. Next is, if you want to hide the feature and the thumbnail image on each of the individual gift card product page, so you have to enable this functionality. And if I keep this option disabled, then it would be up here. Next is disable buyer notification. So if I enable this functionality, then the customer would not be able to get the net notification as soon as he or she is going to send the gift cards to someone. Now, right now I am disabling this option because I want the customers to get the notification as soon as they are going to send the gift cards from the place they are going to buy it. Next is enable product for custom page. So guys, if you want to display the gift card product on any of the custom page, so this feature will help you do that functionality. Now, if you have enabled this option, so definitely you will have to select the custom page on which you want to display the gift card product. So right now you can also see the shortcode, how can you use it. And next, you have to select the custom page. These are the different custom pages. Right now I'm going to select the gift card custom page because I want to display the gift card product over there. And after making all these settings, you have to click on save changes. So guys, this is how easily you can enable or disable the different elements. Now guys, we are going to discuss that how to redeem gift cards at the online stores. So basically, this section is showing you the entire process that is involved in the gift cards redemption, and we are also having the tutorial on this. And guys, I have also mentioned the link of that tutorial in the video description, so you can check it out and understand the entire process. Now guys, I'm going to show you that how can you create a gift card product for your customers in just a quick few steps. So first of all, what you have to do is click on products and then click on add new. Now in this section, you have to mention the name of your gift card product that you're going to create. So let's say I'm mentioning it as happy birthday. And next year, if you want to have a short description about a gift card product, so you have to write it over here. And moreover, you can also add a media attachment. And next, if I scroll it down, so guys, next you have to select the category of your product data. So if I click on this option, you can see that there are various options for product type. So over here, I'm going to select it as gift card since I'm going to create a gift card product. And now you have to make these settings. So first of all, you have to set the default price of your gift card product. So let's say I mention it as 100, and next you have to select the pricing type. So these are the four pricing types. As you can see, right now I will select it as default price. Next is, there's a smaller instruction about your gift card product, as you can see over here. And after this, you have to select the email template for your gift card product that you will be sending to your customers. Right now I have selected a gift for you. Now you can also add the different email templates right from here. These are the different options from where you can select. After this, what comes is give discount. So as if you want to give gift card discounts to your customers, you have to enable this option. And after that, you will be asked that which kind of template you want to be selected by default. So if I show you that that there are different options for selecting the gift card email template, like gift for you or Merry Christmas. So let's say I'm selecting it as gift for you template. So you can also select it as per your wishes. Next is exclude products. So guys, over here you have to select all those products on which you do not want to give gift card coupon amounts to your customers. So you can include the product, you can mention the products over here that will be excluded. Next is exclude category. So over here you have to select all those categories on which you do not want to provide coupons to your customers. Next is include products. So over here you have to select all those products on which the coupons will be provided to your customers. As soon as they are going to purchase these products, they will be able to get the gift card coupons. Next is include category. So you have to select those categories. So these selections you have to do as per your needs and the business requirements. So next guys comes over here is override delivery. So over here you have to, there are three options for the gift card delivery that you can provide to your customer. So if you enable this option, you will also have to select which kind of delivery method you want to provide to your customers. If you enable all these three options, then all these three options will be available to the customers on the front end from where they can select. And if you do not want to enable this option, simply you have to disable this. So let's enable this option, and let's enable one of these options, or you can also go with all of these three. Next is if you want to mention the short product descriptions, you can mention the short description about the gift card product. And after this, let me show you that how can you add the product image. So firstly, you have to select the image that you want to show. So as you can see that the image has been updated. And you can also edit the image right from here. You can also delete the image, as you can see that both the options are available. So this is how you have to select the product image. And as you can see that the product image has been updated. And right after making all the settings, guys, what you have to do is then you have to click on publish, the button that you can see right over here. And as soon as you're going to click on publish, all the settings will be updated and your gift card product has been created. If you want to view your product, so simply you have to click on view product. And yes, here is the gift card product that we have created. You can see this is the product image with all the descriptions, the name of the gift card, the price that we had set, and all the fields that we had enabled, all the delivery options that we have enabled for the customers. All the options are being appeared over here. So guys, this is how easily you can create the gift card products for your customers. Right away you can see that these are the different delivery options, mail, downloadable, shipping, all the sections that we have enabled. So all everything is being appeared over here. And as you can also see that all the email templates that we had provided for the customers, you can see that they are being appeared in the front end. So this is how easily you can create gift card product for your customers. So guys, it's time to understand that how to purchase a gift card products for friends and loved ones, and what are the steps that you are going to follow. So your customers simply move to shop page. And this is the gift card product of Happy Birthday that we have created with the name, with the price. And let's select this gift card and purchase it. So this is the gift card with the price. And let me write the email address and the message that I want to convey. And next, I will set the email address of the recipient right over here. And from here, you can set the quantity of the gift card very easily. And then click on add to cart. So the product has been added to the cart. Let's click on view cart for the further processes. Over here, you have to click on proceed to checkout. And after filling all the required credentials, simply click on place order. So yes, the order for the gift card has been successfully received. So guys, here comes the gift card that has been sent via email to the recipient, and with the coupon code that you can see right over here. And this is the coupon that the gift card recipient will be using during the product purchase. So now it's turn to watch that how to use the gift card coupons during the product purchase. So the gift card recipient will move to the shop page and click on apply coupon. So the coupon has been successfully applied and it has led to the price deduction of the product that has been purchased. So guys, this is how easily you can create and sell amazing e-gift cards to all your customers anytime you want, every time. Now guys, I'm going to discuss about the two features that are offline gift cards and import export feature of our ultimate WooCommerce gift cards plugin. So the very first feature is import offline coupon. So guys, first of all, I would like to tell you that what does this feature do. So if you want to import the offline coupons in bulk, and if you want to provide these coupons to your customers manually, so you can do this with the help of this feature. Simply you have to upload the CSV file with all the gift card details and click on import. Second is offline gift card list. So if you want to provide offline gift cards to your customers, so you have to do the settings that are involved in this, and with the help of add new button that you can see on the very right bottom section, you can create a new offline gift card and then provide to your customers. So guys, over here I would also like to mention that that we are having a separate tutorial on this. We have also mentioned the link in the video description, so you can have a look and understand that how this entire feature is going to work on your WordPress website. Next comes is export coupon. So if you want to provide the online coupon to your customer, so simply what you have to do is you have to export the online coupon details and offline coupon details. And the next feature that comes up is import gift coupons. So if you want to import gift coupons, or if you want to provide the custom coupons to your customers instead of the system generated one, so simply you can do this with the help of this feature. And after this, what comes is import gift products. So if you want to import the gift products along with your own custom course, so you can do this with the help of this feature. So this is how import export feature of our gift card plugins work. Now guys, it's time to understand that how can you enable discount on the gift card products that you have created for your customers. So for this functionality, first you have to move to the tab which is discount, as you can see on the left navigation. So let's click on this, and here comes the discount setting. So first of all, you have to enable this functionality, which is enable discount on gift products. So as soon as you enable this functionality, the coupon will be applicable on the gift card products. And from here, you have to select the discount type, either it can be fixed or percentage. Next, you have to enter the discount within the price range. So you have to set the price range over here at which if your customer is going to place the order for gift card product, then they will be able to avail the coupon which has been provided on that gift card product. So for now, let me mention this value. However, it will depend upon your business needs and the requirements. So let's mention the value over here as 40, and in maximum I am setting it as 120. And for the discount amount, let's say I mention the amount as 20. So if the customer is going to place the order between 40 and 120, he'll get the discount of 20. So this is how you can set the discount settings and provide discounts to your customers on their gift card products. Now guys, I'm going to tell you about the very interesting feature of our plugin, that is how can you give thank you gift card coupons to your customers once they have placed the order for gift card products at your online shop. So this is how you can delight them every time they are going to visit your online store. So for that, you have to first click on thank you order tab in the left side navigation, and here comes the settings of it. So first of all, you have to enable the functionality right from here if you want to give thank you gift card coupons to your customers. Next, you have to select the order status at which you want to send the thank you gift card coupon to them. There are three order status, as you can see in the drop down: order creation, order is in processing, and order is in complete. Now, depending upon your needs and the requirements, you can set the order status. It can be either order creation or it can be either order is in complete. Next is you have to set the number of orders after which the thank you gift card coupon will be sent to your customers. It can be 4 or 5. You can set the values very easy. Next is you have to set the expiration for the thank you coupon. One for 1 day expiry, and if you set the value 0 over here, then there will be no expiration of the thank you coupon. So guys, this is how easily you have to do these settings. And just after this, you have to select the thank you gift coupon type. There are two types, fixed or percentage. It can be fixed or either percentage. After this, you have to select enter the thank you message that would be sent to your customers. So you can also use the short codes over here. And next, you have to mention the coupon amount within order range, like in which order range your customers can avail those thank you coupons. So let's set the value over here. I am in the minimum field, I'm mentioning the amount as 30. In maximum, let's set the value as 150, and let's set the gift coupon amount as 10. So this is how it will work, and if you want, you can also remove this coupon amount. So guys, this is how you can set the thank you order settings and you can give thank you coupons to your customers. Now guys, we are going to discuss about the QR and barcode feature of our gift cards plugin. So first of all, let's click on this tab which is QR code or barcode. And here comes QR code settings. So first of all, you have to enable the QR code right from here, and just after you enable this functionality, instead of the coupon code in the email, what will appear to the customer will be QR code. Then just next after this, you have to select the ECC level for the QR code. So it can be out of these options. Next, you have to select the size of the QR code. Right now it is 3. You can change the values as per your needs. Next is you have to set the margin for the QR code. You can change the values right from here. And just after this, you have to, if you want to enable the barcode on the gift cards that you're going to provide to your customers, you can enable this functionality right from here. Then if you want to display a coupon code, so simply enable this. If you're going to disable this, then the code will not get appeared on the email. Next is you have to select the code type. So there are different options in the dropdown. As you can see, you can select anyone out of this. Next is you have to set the size of the barcode. So after making all these settings, guys, you have to click on save changes. And if you want to reset all these settings, simply you have to click on the button of reset. So this is how you can enable QR and barcode in the gift cards. So guys, this is how QR code and barcode feature of the gift card is going to work for you. Now guys, we are going to discuss about the customizable gift card feature of our plugin. So first of all, let's click on this tab, and here comes the customizable gift card. And the first thing that you have to do is enable gift card, customizable gift card feature right from here. And next, the feature that comes up is allow default template image. So enabling this functionality will help you send the gift cards to your customers through emails. The next feature that comes is allow uploaded template image. So if you enable this functionality, then your customers would be able to upload the images on the gift card printers that they are buying. Next is allow uploaded images and retain default images. So you have to enable this functionality as per your needs. Next, if you want your customer to upload the images for the email template, so you can also do it from here. Simply you have to upload the image like this. So either you can select the file from your system. So I'm selecting the image which is a gift card. So I click on this image, and it has been set, as you can see. And next you have to click on insert into post. So doing this action will upload the image right as you can see over here. So this is how you can upload the image for the email template. Next is upload default gift card image. So from here you can upload the default image that would be appearing on the gift card product. And next, if you want to create another gift card, you have to select this option, and you have to select the entire process. Now guys, we are going to discuss about the different gift card templates that you can find in our plugin. So first of all, you have to click on gift cards and then click on templates. So in the section of templates, you will get a list of all the gift card templates that are there for all the festive seasons and all the occasions that you can think of. So this is the list of all the gift card templates. So now I'm going to click on the preview of one of the gift cards, and let me show you that how this gift card template is going to look like and what are the different elements that are there on it. So here is a preview of Mother's Day gift card template. So you can see that there is a logo, there is a short description with the coupon code details, and this is how the template will look like. Now guys, you can also see the button over here which is import new gift card. So if you want to import the new gift cards, you can do it from here. Simply you have to click on this button, and yes, this is a dashboard which is showing you the collection of all the gift cards from here. You can also look into the individual gift cards by clicking on these options one by one. So and on the left side navigation, if you have to see all the templates at one, you have to click on show all. So like this, if you click on individual gift cards, you will be able to see the details of the individual gift cards like this: for Eid, for Black Friday, for Diwali celebration, for Mother's Day, Father's Day, and for all the occasions. So guys, now let me show you some of the settings, some of the things which is related to the gift cards individually. If you have to import all the gift cards, you can do it from here. Now, let me show you the preview of Mother's Day gift card over here. So this is how it looks like. It is having the logo, as you can see, with the short description. And on this gift card template, you can see the coupon details have been there with the prefix, with the coupon code. And here is a short description about the gift card. And next, it is also having its pricing details. So this is how individual gift card is going to look like. Now guys, you can also replace this gift card with the current one. So for example, if you want to replace the Mother's Day gift card of that list with this one, you have to click on this button. So it will get updated successfully successfully, as you can see the message. Now, for example, if I click on Father's Day gift card and it has been updated. Now, I'm going to show you that how it has been updated and how the changes are going to get reflected. Now, let's click on this preview. So, yes, you can see that the current gift card template for Father's Day has been updated. So, this is how it works. So guys, this is how you can update the gift cards. You can take any of the gift card template that you want to provide to your customers whenever they are going to visit to you. So guys, till now we have understood the settings required for the customizable gift cards feature. Now I'm going to show you the notifications feature of our gift cards plugin. So let's click on this tab and here comes the notification settings. So basically we're having the two sections over here. First is WhatsApp sharing and second is SMS notification. So if you enable the functionality of WhatsApp sharing, then the buyer of the gift card can also send the gift card on WhatsApp. And next is here you have to mention the content that would be sent to the recipient of the gift card. You can also use the short course, as you can see that there is an example using the short course, so mentioning the amount of the gift card and all. Next is SMS notification. So guys, if you enable this functionality, all the gift card details would be sent to the gift card recipients with the help of this feature. And next, you have to, this is a notice. If you want to see the credentials, then you have to visit the website. The link is there. And you have to mention all these details sending the gift card details. And then you have to click on Save Changes. So guys, this is how the notification feature of our gift card plugin works. So guys, this was all about the today's demo video on our premium version of our gift cards plugin. So guys, till now I hope that all the concepts are clear to you, and still if you have any queries and any doubts, you can put them in the comment section. And guys, related to the product, I have mentioned all the related resources in the video description, so you can have a look. And for any queries and any questions that you have, you can reach out to us anytime. We'll feel glad to help you out.